Welcome to CSM Academy, and this video will provide the necessary pre-course information before you embark on your journey with us. CSM Academy International was established in April 2005, offering service management-related programs enhanced by collaborations with overseas universities and organizations. We are committed to providing a high standard of service by promoting an environment conducive to student learning and living. Our lecturers and tutors are not only industry experts, but also dedicated educators passionate about imparting knowledge to their students. We pride ourselves on providing the best education for our students and getting them one step closer in achieving their goals. CSM is registered with the Committee for Private Education, CPE, as a private education institution, PEI, and has been awarded the EduTrust. We strive to maintain our high standards when it comes to conducting and developing quality courses with positive educational outcomes. We are an approved training organization offering WSQ qualifications, and we also offer courses by the International Therapy Examination Council, UK. In addition, our Bachelor in Nursing is accredited by the Singapore Nursing Board. Our vision is to be the premier educator for service excellence. And we aim to achieve this through our mission to inspire passion for service and contribution to society through excellence in continuous education. Through our values, responsibility, integrity, passion, and excellence, we hope to inculcate a culture that provides an open and conducive learning environment with mutual respect and professionalism to build a high-performance organization. Here at CSM, we provide knowledge, share our experience, and equip our students with practical tools across all aspects of customer service and support. This is achieved via
A. Certificates to master's programs.
B. Company-wide in-house training sessions. C. Public seminars. D. Conference with overseas guest speakers. And E. Professional service qualifications. We are located at 250 Sims Avenue in the SPCS building and are closed on Sundays and public holidays. 250 Sims Avenue, number 03-01, SPCS Building, Singapore, 387-513. Contact us through telephone at 629-6262, through email csmsupport@csmacademy.edu.sg. Operating hours: Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Saturday, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Sunday and public holidays, closed. We have a total of
8,000 square feet in two blocks.
That includes 6 classrooms, computer room, library, biomedical lab, student lounge, refreshment corner. CSM also believes in taking care of our students' welfare and needs through the following touch points. 1. Student Orientation Program. 2. Counseling Services. 3. Dispute Resolution. 4. Medical Insurance. 5. Staff to Student Dialogue Sessions. And 6. Student Activities. You may refer to the Student Handbook for the full list of services. Please go to www.csmacademy.edu.sg to download our course brochures, which will have the following information: entry requirements, course learning outcomes, course modules and outlines, course duration and assessment information, graduation requirement, type of certification awarded, opportunities for further education or job prospect after graduation, total payable fee. Apply for your preferred course by filling in the form online and uploading your documents along with the application fee. We will look through your application and notify you of the outcome. Upon successful application for internal programs, CSM Academy will issue the Letter of Offer, LOO, to the successful applicant. For external programs, the partner will issue the official Letter of Offer. For international students, CSM Academy will submit his or her student pass application to the Immigration and Checkpoint Authority, ICA, for approval. If you're a local student, please ensure you have the following items ready: completed application form, digital passport size photograph, certificates and transcripts, highest education qualification, and Photocopy of NRIC. Copy of resume. Submission date, at least 14 days before commencement of course. If you're an international student, please ensure you have the following items ready. Application form. Copies of ICA Form 16 and V36. Digital photographs. Highest education qualification verified by the school attended or embassy. If the original is not in English, a translated copy will be required. Photocopy of passport or ID. Copy of application's birth certificate. English translation required if not in English. Bank statement of the past 1 month. Proof of English proficiency, if applicable. Resume or letter from employer. Certifying period of employment, if applicable. Submission date, at least 2 months before commencement of course. Do take note of the following information as we cover some important policies and information. The Standard Private Education Institution Student Contract, or Student Contract, is a very important legal document between the school and the student. It encompasses 1. Course information and fees. 2. Course information and fees refund policy, including refunds for withdrawal for cause and refunds for withdrawal without cause. 3. Any other information as deemed necessary. The Fee Protection Scheme, FPS, serves to protect the student's fees in the event a private education institution, PEI, is unable to continue operations due to insolvency and/or regulatory closure. The FPS also protects the student if the PEI fails to pay penalties or return fees to the student arising from judgments made against it by the Singapore courts. FPS is compulsory for both local and international students taking courses at the school, except for courses with waiver granted by CPE. FPS assurance of the payable fees are protected under this scheme, except for the following. 1. Course application fees. 2. Prevailing goods and services tax, GST. 3. Miscellaneous fees. 4. FPS insurance premium. 5. Re-examination fee. FPS is not applicable to student taking courses with a duration of not more than 1 month or 50 hours or courses with waiver from CPE. The school uses LonPAC Insurance BHD. Once CSM has purchased the fee protection coverage for the student's course fee paid, you will receive an email from our FPS provider. For more information, visit CPE's website, https://www.cpe.gov.sg/. Effective 1 November 2015, Singapore Citizens SC and Singapore Permanent Residents SPR will be covered under the new MediShield Life Scheme, and thus no additional medical insurance will be purchased for these students. We have purchased a group medical insurance scheme for all our students, except SC/SPR. This medical insurance scheme covers up to B2 wards, or 6 better wards. Conditions apply in Singapore government and restructured hospitals, and provides for 24 hours coverage in Singapore and overseas if student is involved in school-related activities throughout the course duration. The mandatory medical insurance purchase described above does not apply to students studying on a part-time basis or those taking courses that are no more than 30 days or 50 hours in duration. Every student is covered under individual medical insurance with Etika Insurance Berhad. For international students not on student pass and students under corporate sponsorship may opt out of the medical insurance scheme if you have your own medical insurance and can provide proof. We ensure that a fair and reasonable refund policy is detailed for any payments made. Time taken to process all refund requests will be done within 7 working days. This policy will act as a framework in guiding the implementation of detailed refund processes and procedures in the following areas. 1. Refund for withdrawal due to non-delivery of course. 2. Refund for withdrawal due to other reasons. 3. Cooling off period. 4. School refund policy as per clauses in the standard student contract. Refund for withdrawal due to non-delivery of course. The school notified the student within 3 working days upon knowledge of any of the following. 1. It does not commence the course on the course commencement date. 2. It terminates the course before the course commencement date. 3. It does not complete the course by the course completion date. 4. It terminates the course before the course completion date. 5. It has not ensured that the student meets the course entry or matriculation requirement as set by the organization stated in Schedule A of the standard student contract within any stipulated timeline set by CPE, or 6. The student's pass application is rejected by Immigration and Checkpoints Authority, ICA. The student should be informed in writing of alternative study arrangements, if any, and also be entitled to a refund of the entire course fees and miscellaneous fees already paid should the student decide to withdraw within 7 working days of the above notice. Refund for withdrawal due to other reasons. If the student withdraws from the course for any reason other than those stated in Clause 2.1 of the Standard Student Contract, the PEI will, within 7 working days of receiving the student's written notice of withdrawal, refund to the student an amount based on the table in Schedule D of the Standard Student Contract. Refund during cooling off period. The PEI will provide the student with a cooling off period of 7 working days after the date that the contract has been signed by both parties. The student will be refunded the highest percentage stated in Schedule D of the Standard Student Contract of the fees already paid if the student submits a written notice of withdrawal to the school within the cooling off period, regardless of whether the student has started the course or not.
Non-refundable fees. Miscellaneous fees are non-refundable. Notes. Conditions where a course may be canceled. 1. The intake does not meet a minimum enrollment of 15 students. 2. The teacher is suddenly hospitalized and a substitute teacher cannot be found. Transfer or withdrawal policy. A student who requests for an internal course transfer within the school must have their existing contract terminated. A new student contract will be signed based on the procedures for executing student contracts. The refund policy shall apply unless as otherwise agreed between the school and the student. The student must also fulfill all the admissions criteria of the new course and be subjected to the school's student selection and admission procedures. A student who withdraws from the school to enroll with another school shall be deemed to have withdrawn from the school, and the refund policy and procedures shall apply. All outstanding fees must be settled prior to request for withdrawal and or transfer. Student is to submit course transfer or withdrawal request form, including submission of any supporting documents online, and adhering to the process as stated in the course transfer and withdrawal procedures. Conditions for refund. The school's refund policy shall apply for all qualified refunds. Students are to refer to the school's refund policy and the standard student contract for further details. Student pass status. For course transfers. For students pass holder, course transfer is subject to ICA's approval of new students pass. In the event that an application pertaining to transfer is rejected by ICA, the student pass is to be canceled within 7 days. For course withdrawals, students pass holder is required to submit his or her passport and students pass to the school for cancellation of students pass with ICA. The entire transfer or withdrawal process will not take more than 4 weeks.
Additional information. Here's some other information you may find helpful if you're new to Singapore. Our healthcare facilities are first class, and you can seek medical assistance at the following places depending on your needs. Hospital, polyclinic, private clinic. Set up your phone line and Wi-Fi with any of our telcos. Reception island-wide. Singtel, StarHub, M1. Getting around in Singapore is super convenient. Our train and bus services run from early morning to night, or you can always grab a taxi or Uber. Cost of living in Singapore. Opt for room sharing for more affordable living arrangements and make sure you have enough set aside for meals. Accommodation. Dual sharing room. S$600 packs per month. Triple sharing room. S$500 packs per month. Quad sharing room. S$450 packs per month. Food, average of $3 to $5 packs per meal. Many of our local laws are different from the laws of your own home country. Be sure to check out our laws and penalties they carry, as they may be far more severe than what you expect. Some of the laws are as follows. Immigration and Checkpoint Authority Regulations and Laws. Ministry of Manpower Regulation and Laws. No working in Singapore on student pass. Drugs and alcohol abuse. Smoking. Vandalism. Littering. Student passes application. Accurate and updated information need to be provided. Personal particulars. Educational qualifications. Financial ability. Family background. Security deposit. In addition to furnishing these info, you may be required to attend an interview in person. This pass grants you permission to stay in Singapore and pursue the studies approved by the Singapore government. It also states the period of time that the student is allowed to stay. International students are also forbidden from working, whether for payment or not. Depending on immigration law, you may be required to pay a certain amount of security deposit to ICA. This info is available at www.ica.gov.sg. Lastly, students can refer to the CPE website for more details. 1 Marina Boulevard, number 18-01, 1 Marina Boulevard, Singapore, 018989. Telephone 656512-1140. Email
cpe_contact@cpe.gov.sg.
Website www.cpegov.sg. Opening hours, Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Saturday, Sunday, and public holidays, closed. Thank you for your time to go through this pre-counseling video, and we hope to see you join us soon.